Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting. Again, we're using the artisan oils, water mixable oils. I've become a huge fan of these, mainly because you can paint and you don't need any harmful mediums. I mean, I got myself a bottle of linseed oil and I have water, so that's all I really need. And so I'm really enjoying using these. I've got this picture that I printed out, and this one as well, of the sea for reference. And I've got my canvas all set up. It's a canvas board, and I painted it with some brown, some raw umber acrylic paint, so it's ready for me to paint on. The only reason why I paint them brown is so I can see the colour going on. When the canvas is pure white, I can't quite see the lights and darks as well. I mean, it's not something you have to do, it's just something I've started doing, and I find it works quite well. I'm just going to put some paint on the palette and we'll get started. Colours. Okay, I've loaded my palette with some paint, and I've got some cobalt blue over here, got my blue over here, and my titanium white, which I'll probably need more. I'll just put that much out for now. I've got some viridian green. I think I might need some in the rocks. Maybe some in the water. Not sure. Some cadmium yellow, because we will need some of that in with to make maybe the sail. It's got a bit of yellow in. Maybe I'll use this view. Yeah, that's a bit better. Yeah, you can see the sail. It's got a little bit of yellow. To get that blue, we're looking at cobalt blue and maybe yellow. Not sure. And then we've also got black for the rocks. Let's go on to this image. There's a lot of black in the rocks, lots of greys. And then we've got this wave in, and we'll decide what colours we're going to use. We'll do a wave similar to that, but because I really like this colour for the sea, I'm going to use that. So first things first, actually, I'll just get a little bit of white, a little bit of the titanium white on my brush. I'm kind of going to draw very loosely things that I want in the picture. So my horizon line's quite high, so I'll have my horizon lines up there along sort of that area, and I'll mist it away. We've got rocks using the other picture. There's rocks that come sort of there down. Bit of a bay there, and rock comes up there. I quite like that rock there. Then there's the wave. There's a rock in front of it here. There's a rock there. So I'm only using a little bit of white, so when we put the colour on, it won't make a great deal of difference, because it'll just get rid of it. And then we've got the wave crashing here. Sort of crashing along like that. And then there's more rock over here, although I'm going to shrink that area. I'll have the rock sort of go over there. Something like that. And then might have a rock in here as well. We'll decide that at a later date. And then we've got a boat. Now I think the boat should live somewhere around here, I would say. So I'll just sketch the boat in, the sail. Something like there. Thinking what kind of size I'm going to want this. So I'm just sketching. Yeah, it's not quite right. I think we're going to have to make it smaller. It's alright. Just using a little wipe. Just lightly wipe it away. Paper. Okay, it's easy, just got rid of it. Yeah, I'm thinking because the boat's quite big in that, I don't want it anywhere near as big as that. I want some, maybe I'll start with the actual base of the boat, sort of. Something like that. I'm doing it quite big again. Maybe it will suit that size, isn't it? It's too bad actually. I thought it was going to look way too big. But you got to try it out and see how it looks. And then the sail, sort of there. It's about as big as that. So let's say bring it to there, and then the other ones there, and then it goes round. That's catching the wind. This one. Something like that. Very rough. Okay, so what I want first is the sky colour. So what we do, we obviously need blue. I'm mixing this light blue sky now. Up quite all right. We've got some white and the cobalt blue. I'm going with cobalt blue today rather than ultramarine, just for different, really, something different. And straight away, my blue is too light. Yellow. bit more yellow in there. Come for a bit more. It's gone a bit too green. So a bit more white. That's looking pretty close. A bit more white. I think we're quite close now. Yeah, we're very close. So I think that'll do. That'll do. So we've got a nice blue sky. And we'll leave some room for clouds. So I'm just having a look. Nice to have clouds in the sky, of course. Just moving my light. Just loading my brush. And having a look. Putting the sky in. I could use a bigger brush, actually. Wipe that one, put it in my little brush holder, and go for this bigger one, because we can get more of this area painted quicker. So it's just a bit of blue, bit of yellow, and some white for the sky colour. Blue, yellow, and white. You can always go darker if you wish, or lighter. Okay, just loading my brush both sides. And just sort of glancing at the shape of the boat. Kind of painting around it. We can improve this as we go though. You could do an improved version also. This just shows you how to do it. Okay, put some sky in there. I actually think, looking at it, I could probably darken the colour a touch. Give it a bit more blue. Yeah. Get a tiny drop of water, just so it flows a bit better. Paint this just filling it in. You can mix colour on the canvas. I just wanted it to get a bit more blue towards the horizon, so we'll do that. More water in the paint. Okay. Just go back into that blue again. Mix it. I need a bit more light, but I don't wanna try to set the light up so it's not blinding. It's still seeable by the camera, which is tricky. I'm just filling it in. Takes a bit of time. You can use a bigger brush, mix a bigger amount of paint if you wish. Once I get the idea of the colour, I just sort of casually mix it. It's not quite as I'm quite as strict with myself. It's mainly the tone that I'm after, and the and then look for the colour, but. You can be creative and change things. You don't have to have it exactly like the picture. Oh, I filled all this in and I was going to put a cloud there. Oh well, we'll put a cloud there still. Excuse my left ear a bit. Painting is one of those things that is possible with both hands, I find. I can't write with both hands. I can put paint on a canvas. Maybe not so much the detail. Maybe I'd struggle a bit there. But it is a little bit hard actually. How are we looking? Still want that blue at the base. You see, if you had a white canvas now, you wouldn't quite see the tone. It does make it harder. I know I say that a lot. I'm just amazed when I started using it how much easier it is. Okay. Right, we want a bit of a blue glow, so let's just put a little bit of a bit more of a blue glow at the base. It's okay that it blends away a bit. I just want our horizon to have some blue in it. Okay then, sit back have a look. Looking at the camera screen. Not sure if it's a bit too. Bright. Let's look at this horizon line now. There. You can use masking tape or draw in the horizon line if you wish to get it right. Today I opted for just throwing the want to see the top. Don't want to miss this area out with paint. You have to remember when you're doing your painting that some of it is going to be behind a frame. So the very edges, you kind of need to paint it, but you need to remember that everything is slightly in. So you don't want something important in that area. Like if you was doing a portrait, you wouldn't want the horse's ear to be slightly off or something. That makes sense. Never mind. Let's put in a cloud. I'm just getting a bit of brown and white. Brown and white. Put a cloud in sort of here. Gonna need more white because it's gonna mix with the colour that we've got on there. White. Thinking like a cloud. Just using round strokes. Gone a bit overboard with the brown there. Let's move away from that. Yeah, that's what I wanted, sort of a brown tone in the cloud. Sort of warms the cloud up. Like that. Just sit back and have a look and then make decisions on where you want a bit more light. I think it would look good for the tops of the clouds to be lighter. Okay. And then maybe a little bit of a cloud there. Maybe a little stringy ones there. Maybe a little bit more here. Yeah, that'll do. And then I can use my soft brush. I can soften it. There we go. Nice and soft. That's all we need for our cloud anyway. We don't want to get too overboard with it. So now, what I want is to start the water. So So I've got this idea of the water around the rocks. So, and we want this sort of colour. Just wipe my my plastic thing. Okay, we're going for this colour now. So I want some blue. I'll hold it there so you might see it. Some blue. I can use this pile, this is okay. Because it's got some of the, I think it needs a bit of green in it. So we've got viridian green and blue. Maybe a bit of brown as well. Well, that's destroyed it. That was too much brown. Let's get some of that green in. We might be close now. Actually, it's very dark, but let's just move it over here and get some white. I think we're quite close. We're we need a little bit more blue. But it's not bad. So just get me a bit more blue. Put all the cobalt. Put that blue in there. Just wipe my brush here and then go into this bit of white. Gives me an idea of the colour. Okay. It needs a bit more yellow. Yeah, I'm quite happy with that colour. It's not exactly the same. But, if you can see it very well, I'm not sure. I can use it all. It's not exactly the same. Well, it's dark. It's more like this sort of dark. But it's pretty close. You could see that. It differently. It's there. I mean, it's not the same, but it's, I mean, it's close though. Mine, I would say, is a little less blue by a tiny amount. But I want it to be fairly dark anyway. Let's go with something like this. I quite like it. So we've got our boat. Put our blue in. We've got the sea behind. See, I'm working into the paint that's already there. Just going up into it. Just so that the water that we're throwing on sort of blends up into the sky, and you get like that nice misty effect where you can't quite see where the sky and the sea meet. I like it when it's like that. Oh, we've blobbed some up there. Anyway, let's get this soft brush. We'll go along it, along the horizon. You can see it just blends together. Sitting back, having a look at what we've got, seeing what could be improved. So it'd be nice to have the ship painted now, and then we can work around it. Just looking at the got the ruler out. It's pretty close to being level, but it doesn't look quite level to me. Yeah, it's above 10 on this side. It's below on this side. I hope my head didn't just get in the way then. That looks about right now. Right, let's I'll leave this brush in the pot there, and this one, and we'll look at doing the boat. Use a finer brush. So we've got a couple of sails. We need some more sky as well, actually. That sail is way thinner than that. That we can get rid of that there. Okay. Use this brush, get a bit of this brown and some white. A bit of yellow. Yeah, I quite like that colour. So a little yellow, a little of this brown. With the white. Okay. So we're looking at getting this in. of the easel just to hold myself steady. Maybe this area that I haven't painted yet. That's the only thing when you're doing these. You need something to hold you steady. I use my other hand, so I get the angle there. Sort of goes at that angle. That goes round. Something like that. Yeah. We can always clean that up with a bit of sky colour. Grab another brush. Not that one. Want a filbert type. Get some of this sky. Looking at that, our boat should be a bit higher, but let's carry on. I need this one. Sail. This sail is, looking at it, it's actually quite thin. Let's try and get this fairly straight at least. I think this is a bit too much. Maybe there. Yeah, that's not too bad. Like I said, it doesn't have to be perfect. Well, mine doesn't. But when you're doing it, you can spend lots of time getting it right. Certainly having a good go at making it look alright though. So it seems. Right, let's start putting the boat in. So really the boat should be higher. That should be about there. The roof. Let's fill that in. I'm going to put in the detail afterwards. It's funny how rough it looks when you're doing it. That should be about there. Something like that. Okay. Got some water up there. And there's some areas I can use this same colour actually to get a few of the detail in. Let's pull them brushes down a minute. Just looking at this is here so I can have a bit of a window there. Window there and on there. There's a doorway here. Yeah. Go back into my other colour, use another brush, and I can clean that up there and that there. Sort of a back and forth tango now. Create some light areas. I mean, this boat is quite far out, so you wouldn't see everything. But what we do want is to create an illusion. There's one there. Maybe a indication of a couple of buoys there and one hanging there. I mean, you could really spend a long time creating this boat, putting all the little details in. just kind of building it up really. Just sort of sitting back having a look, and I'm thinking, what would you see that would stand out to you? The white of the pole. We'll use our hand again. The sail would be a little lighter. That part of the sail maybe would catch a bit of light. It would be the pole that runs across here as well. Okay, let's get a bit of that brown again. And we'll put some slight little marks. I think what I might do, get some of this yellow, just put the indication of someone on there, just a little bit of yellow there. Use this brush with the blue on it, is that okay? Get some of this black. A little bit of black, and then put a tiny head on him. Maybe we'll have one that stands out a bit more. Drop a red. This is cadmium red. Oh, I've just got into some black by accident. Why do that? Although that colour's not too bad. Put someone else in there. That was amusing. Couple of people. We can improve this further. A bit of this brownie red. Do this floor here. And get some pure white. Get a bit of this grey. and I'm probably spending a bit too much time now on this. I don't want this lesson to go on forever. So, let's leave that boat. Otherwise, I will take ages on it, and before you know it, an hour has gone by. Or 2 hours. And I just wanted to put in a very basic boat. I can't help but look at it now and think, wouldn't it be better if it's a bit darker there? And then it's not quite what I had in mind. It's just lighter than that now. It's a bit better. Could do with a little. Okay, we'll leave it at that, because we can't spend too much longer on it. Like I said, you could spend ages on it, you could get it, refine it and refine it and refine it before you know it. We spent too long on it, but that's quite far away, we wouldn't see a huge amount of detail. So now we're gonna start putting in some waves. And we've got this wave turning over as well. So we want this wave turning over, it's going to be about here. This is the colour. Turn it over. It sort of goes up there. Throwing in little bits of light. Get the boat moving. And I want it even lighter now when it comes over. So we've got sort of that colour, and then it gets a bit lighter. Maybe that's too light. Yeah, maybe that. Sort of like that. But then I need another brush. Needs to come over. Might use the soft brush actually. gets a bit darker again. It's hitting. A little bit lighter there. Now I get some white and start thinking about where it's all foaming. It's a bit of a rock there, so we'll that sort of watery effect. And then to improve this, I'm just going to pull some over. A bit more white. Okay, then we can go back to our dark colour. Go with leaf. Looking at that boat, I just think it's too white. I just feel like it needs to be more blued, but be okay. We'll leave it. Yeah, that's better. Get a bit of white. The white colour. The dark colour. indication of the light there is on the wave. It's almost there. I think that works quite well. Right, let's get a bit of more fresh white on the palette. And hit some of these areas. A bit more of the light. Bring some this over. I think that works. That does look like water. Anyway, let's have a look. We need to start thinking about this rock area. Let's brushes have we got in there? Let's use this big brush. Actually, we can use that. Yeah, use a big brush. Let's get some of this black and brown. Some of this colour. It's quite dark. Grab a bit of that sea colour. Throw that in a lot. Grabbing black and brown. There's even a bit of yellow in there. Not too worried. Same in this side. Put some of the dark in the water as well. Just gonna close this. Looking at that, I want more sort of lines. Yeah, that's better. Looks more moving now. It's moving out. Also, So now, just grabbing some of this black sky colour, blue in it, blue and brown. We can start creating this. There's a bit of yellowy green in there as well. I'm just sort of dropping in some light. On the rock. Not really too much on that bit of rock. Get some of this blue. Keep this one quite dark. Feel like I could spend a lot more on this to improve it. I'm itching to do more, but let's carry on. Let's bring this water down. I can imagine it splashing, maybe there's a rock under there. Let's come over a little bit and it is splashing around a rock. We'll put a rock in there. Settling down over this way. Didn't have a wave for a bit, so that's sort of settled. In fact, that would probably be darker than that. sort of just seeing things that I want to do and I just do it. A bit of colour on the rock. It'd be nice to break that up there. Yeah, I prefer that. Let's get a bit of this brownie colour. Put in a bit of a beach. An effect that there's a bit of a beach there. And a bit of white sort of around this area. Some little splashes here. You can start putting water on the rocks if you wish as well. A little bit there. Sort of sitting back and looking to see what I would like. Maybe a rock there. Maybe another one. I'm using a darker white, so a bit of white with a bit of blue I can always sort of come across and when I look at it, I think it's too bright. I think it needs toning down. So using a bit of blue. Having that improves it quite a lot. Obviously the angle of the water looks a bit off. I think the water angle would be there. Yeah, I think that's a bit better. Okay, now I'm gonna put the little boys back in. There was one there, I think. One there. And there was a couple of little I'll leave it at that. That's better than what it was. Just want a bit of pure white there, just on the top of the boat. Just want that a little bit. make it hard on myself by doing it small. But I just wanted to make it look half decent. Give you an idea of what you can do. You could even draw it on the canvas first, so you get it accurate, and then paint it. Just fill it in. But I just wanted to show you how to do a painting of a seascape with a boat on it, and hope you enjoyed it. Hope it gives you an idea. And I could add splashes, and I could go in with a liner and do all sorts to it. But I think I'll leave it at that. So thank you very much for watching this one. I hope it helps you out in some way. And I'll see you at another episode. Cheers. Bye.